The first four edits don't have audios, so just watch how crappy these are. I'm just gonna talk over them like as they go. Oh my god, I literally don't even remember making this. I don't remember making this one either.
Because on set it's just great.
Oh my god, I'm literally... The scaling of this, I literally cannot. I... Oh my god. Oh, this coloring is horrendous. I don't remember making this one. I have, like, no memory of this. Oh my god. Brina! Oh my god. I don't remember this one. Okay, the next edit has an audio, so I'm gonna stop talking now.
French pimp bump back in the day. I take her to Ponderay and I watch her skate. I mean water ski, Ollie Ollie oxen free. I'm perusing down.
My only, you won't be lonely, even if the sky is falling down.
With your direction.
I always wanted to fuck that bitch. Thank you God I fucked that bitch. I always wanted to live this life.
If I stay here, would you come back? If I stay cool, would you be mad? Would you want me if I want you?
Don't be scared, I'm right here.
May God be with you all.
She gon' flirt in front of her nigga. She like, fake, oh, you gettin' bigger.
grab your wrist. Had to be a better boyfriend than him. I could tell the shit that he never did. Up on that, I won't quit. Thinking I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus all my cocks would fit.
Addicted to the knife.
Addicted to the knife?
Addicted to the knife.
And addicted to the knife, she needs a little help with the agony.
Agony.
And a little help comes in a little glass vial and a gun pressed against her anatomy. And when the gun goes off, Miss Sweet is ready for surgery. Surgery.
And not the kind that's thrown. I mean the kind under where a tree has grown.
I'm so in love that I might stop breathing through a map on your bedroom ceiling. No, I didn't see the knife.
Sorry for your loss.
Your signals are missed. You act like a bitch. You fit every stereotype in the pit. Half the sun is sweating like a feather with you out my life. With you out my life.
They don't know how much I miss her. I wish I could buy her. I'd pick you up and we go back.
Okay, so like the entire purpose of me like making this was like, oh, not to like flex of how I got better or anything like that. Like, I'm not gonna flex over editing. So don't take that as me adding like better edits at the end. Like, that was not like my goal. My goal was to show you how like I literally started off at absolute shit. Those first few that were just like horrendously just horrible. That was like in like 2016, so it took me like years to get better, like years. I have a lot more that are just generally really bad, so don't even. I have way more. It took me years to get better, but I made this because if you're out there and you're like, oh my god, my edits suck or I'll never get better, it takes time. And I've seen a lot of editors that literally have only edited for like a year to 2 years and they are just mind-blowingly better than me. And I remember at the time when I was still improving, I was like so jealous of these people. But it's like now I actually make decent enough edits to where they're not what my first edits look like. And some edits I'm actually proud of, some edits were actually genuinely just it could have been better. It's like I still struggle with graphs or whatever. But I think that I've improved a lot from those first edits. And I remember at the time when I was making edits that terrible, I was like, oh my god, I'm never gonna get better. I'm gonna quit. And there was so many times I literally would have quit. But I am so, so glad I didn't. And I went through so many accounts just getting frustrated about not blowing up and stuff like that. But now I don't care about blowing up. Like, I have reached a few edits that did and I'm grateful for that, but it's just fun now. Like, I'm doing something that I love so much that is so much fun. But it took me a long, long time to get here. I've literally been editing since like you could say 2015, but back in like 2015, I was doing like photo edits. I was doing a few video edits, but that's why I said I go way back. I literally go back to when I was using like PowerDirector and like Viva Video and CuteCut, if any of you guys remember those apps. So like I've been at it for a while. But so to the edits that I improved at, you can tell which ones just like needed help with like graph wise and it just wasn't pieced together very well and that I consider scraps. So I want to go into that and why, like, I showed these and then I showed the ones that were decently better than the other ones. Okay, so like there's so much to say about this one because like if anybody's been on TikTok, I'm pretty sure you've seen how toxic it's gotten, but honestly, for like the past 3 years, the editing community just got insanely toxic. But like I didn't have TikTok at first. What made me get TikTok is because I was watching like Lauren's, if you know the editor Lauren Emohu from Whoville, I was watching Lauren's like undercover accounts, and I think her first one was the Charlie one, and I made my TikTok because I wanted to like watch her undercover videos in case she like did more or whatever, and I don't know. So if you wonder why like my feed on my account is just like such a mess, it's because when I made my TikTok, like I was still posting my edits, but like I wasn't expecting like anything. I didn't have a theme. I didn't think I was gonna blow up or anything like that, so I just posted whatever because I didn't really care. I just made it honestly to kind of just watch Lauren and other editors and stuff like that. So when I first posted, they kind of blew up, but like just views wise, like I still didn't really have anybody that just like commented being like, wow, this is so cool. So it didn't really blow up until I will show the other one next. It didn't really blow up until that one edit that I remade from Lauren. That was the first one that ever blew up, and it was so wild because like that edit was just obviously super bad, but like people were like really cool about it. Anyway, back to this edit. I was kind of like nervous about this because like at first I was like super proud of it, but so many people gave it backlash, and then there's other people that were like, this is so good, and giving me constructive criticism and saying that like I just needed to work on the graphs or whatever. And then I was also seeing just like the other remakes from this edit, and they were just so much better on than mine. But I already knew like when I made this edit, it wasn't going to be like insanely good because I don't know how to edit the way Lauren does. And so like I knew that making this, but to see that, you know, at the time, like, these comments actually, I sound like they got to me, but, like, I was more so just insecure about, like, other people's edits looking better than mine, not what other people had to say about mine, because, like, I remember seeing her edit, and it's, like, so many people were, like, laughing at my edit and laughing at my graphs, but it was just so funny to me, because I'm, like this edit was just, like, this edit was just like hard, and like people just like laughed at me as if this was some simple basic transition edit and I was just supposed to perfect it and just be good at it. And especially because I use After Effects, and everybody just expects every After Effects editor to just be great and just edit like Lauren, and I am just, unfortunately to you guys, I'm not one of those people. I'm not great at After Effects and I don't edit like Lauren, and this edit was just obviously not really as good as the other remakes. However, as I look at it now, it's not a completely terrible edit. Obviously, like, the graphs could have been better and it could have been better, but because I don't know how to make it the way Lauren did, it just was in my own way and I worked hard on it, so I don't really care about what those people say because, like, it was fun, and so that's all that matters. I just kind of feel like, okay, this is not a podcast, but this is not a podcast. Let me just end what I'm going to say. Basically, overall, it's just like, yes, I put this edit as kind of a scrap because, not because it's not as good as other people, but there's just so much more I could have done better. Like, now I think I would have edited this a little bit better. I actually kind of watched Lauren's tutorials on my graphs and stuff like that, since so many people were giving me, like, comments about that, but I actually was just like, maybe I should, like, maybe I'll learn from her. I was like, if I understand it, I'll use her graphs. If I don't, then I'll just edit how I was before. And so I watched her graphs video and I think I've gotten better a lot. So actually, those people actually generally helped me. Yeah, I didn't ask for the constructive criticism, the ones that were like rude, but like, I'm actually glad that they gave it to me. And so now I think I've improved, but I just feel like we're all at some point gonna make scrap edits. It just happens. This wasn't my best, but this also wasn't my worst. But people love putting like your edits that like weren't the worst as your worst. But you can't really let that get to you. Like, this is not like my worst edit ever. My worst edits were the first edits I put in this video. But at the very start, those were my worst edits. So I'm like, why did that, the way that I said that literally sounded so weird. Oh my God, I like sound so nervous. And I'm, anyway, this isn't my worst, but it's also not my best. Not because of what other people said, but because I generally, like, it's just not my best. So I wanted to put this as one of them, just like being a scrap, because obviously I could have changed graph wise. And so I say all this to say, it's like some edits were really good, and then there's edits like this where it's like they obviously could have looked so much better.
Not grab your wrist. I could be a better boyfriend than him. I could do the shit that he never did. Up on that, I won't quit. Thinking I'm gonna steal you from him. I could be such a gentleman. Plus all my cocks would fit.
Okay, so this one was my absolutely favorite one. I remember when this song, before the song even came out, I think like Dove Cameron was like teasing it a little bit. She almost didn't release this song, and I'm so glad she did. But as soon as she came out with this, I could already see like the edit in my head. But like, weirdly enough, I actually was gonna like make like an, okay, so you know how like Lauren or like Vivian has like, or more so Vivian, if you know the editor Vivian. So basically the editor Vivian, like, she did this YouTube video where she had Snapchat AI make her edit. It was kind of like that with me, but I kind of had like a spin the wheel, like choose like my edit. So like the spin of wheel, like choose, like, oh my God, choose. Like the spin of wheel, like, chose the song that I was gonna use. And I had put like boyfriend in like the one of the lists. And so it landed on that, and it was perfect because I could already see, like, who I was, I mean, not, like, who, but, like, what I could do with the edit. But then I, like, realized, like, who I could do it with, because I thought it was just so perfect to do, like, Lily and Cole, and, like, I was such, like, a huge Lily Reinhardt stan. I'm not, like, necessarily a stan anymore, still love her, but at the time, like, I was kind of, like, a Lily Reinhardt stan. And so I was like, oh my God, this is perfect, because like everyone knows, like, her and Cole Sprouse broke up. So I immediately just had this idea in mind, and I don't really plan my edits. I just open After Effects and just like wing it. But like, I kind of already had this edit in my head already, because I could already just hear it with the lyrics. And so I made this, and I actually, this was like just one of my favorite edits ever. I wouldn't say ever, this is actually one other edit that was one of my favorites, but this was like just really fun to do, really loved doing this one. And then obviously like that last transition was inspired by Lauren, but besides that, for the most part, like this edit just was like in my head, and I was like, oh my God. And so I think I did a pretty good job on it. Like, obviously the graphs could be better, but how many times am I going to say that? Obviously, the graphs could be better. I literally feel like I'm reading. I'm not, but I like literally actually feel like I'm reading my TikTok comments. And you know what's so funny? I actually like don't reread TikTok comments too much. Like, I read them when they first come in, but like, I don't always go back and read them. Like, it's, I do it maybe once, barely even once every few months. I don't really reread them a lot anyway. But yeah, like, when I posted this, everyone's giving me, like, constructive criticism, which they were all really nice. I think I saw one of somebody just, like, laughing at me, and I was just, like, it was just kind of funny to me, because I was, like, this edit really is not that bad. My graphs, I've seen my graphs be worse than this. This was a decent, good edit. So it's just, like, every time I see somebody laughing in the comments on someone's edit, it's just so embarrassing for them. Like, this, my god, it's just so embarrassing for them. Like, I swear, if you don't edit like Lauren, like, TikTok people are just gonna come at you. And it's actually really funny because Lauren actually commented on this edit. Like, I saw the notification when I, like, was on my phone, and I was so scared because I was, like, so scared because I was like, oh my god, like, is she gonna hate this? Is she gonna say this? I don't know why. And, like, Lauren is, like, so nice, but, like, no, like, she just gave me a compliment. And that was, like, really cool. And so I saw that notification, and I was like, oh my goodness, because I'm guessing that edit was probably on her For You page. So that was just, like, really cool. But I actually, yeah, this is one of my favorite edits. Love this edit. People still laughed at it. I think it was probably, like, one or two people or something like that. But, like, I just didn't care because I was like, this is actually a decent edit. Like, oh my god. So, yes, obviously the graphs could have improved. But, like, this was, like, way better, I feel like, than the one that I remade for Lauren. So, I still like this edit. I could remake it one of these days. I just might. This is actually one of my favorite edits.
I'm so sorry for your loss.
You say it knows a miss. You act like a bitch. You fit every stereotype in the pit. I lost the sun and sweating like a feather with you out my life. With you out my life.
Okay, so I think this is the last edit that I'm going to review because I think you get the point at this point. But I'm actually really insecure about this edit. Like, the idea was there because I had saw Sabrina's TikTok, like, with the intro, and she had used this song because this is obviously her song. It's called Feather. It's so good. Go listen to it if you haven't. But I was like, I immediately just already knew what I wanted to do with the song. I knew I wanted to use a feather transition. Like, I just kind of, the idea was just kind of already there, but the execution was not. I don't think this is the worst edit, but I do consider this a little bit of a scrap because it's just kind of all over the place. And there was one part where I had a different idea. Okay, so, like, when I did, like, the, oh, I can't even see that in my head, but I kind of can. There was, like, a part where I kind of did, like, the devil wings, so, like, the angel part. And I had a different idea than that. When she said your signals are mixed, like, I wanted to do, like, a traffic light and some kind of, like, transition. But when I was trying to do it, I just could not execute it right. And so that idea just went down the drain. But that would have been, I feel like, so much cooler than what I had did. And I don't know, just, like, the graphs just aren't it. And then, like, the end with, like, the video, I just feel like I ruined it. And so I really would love to remake this edit because I feel like I can execute it a lot better and just make it a lot smoother and try again, maybe with the traffic light idea, maybe. I don't know, maybe I can try experimenting with that. But this edit, in my opinion, it's not the worst, but it's a scrap. So it was just a little bit of a mess. It's actually kind of funny because somebody that follows me and I follow back, like, on my Instagram, they, like, told me, like, in a DM, and you know who you are if you're watching this, they told me in a DM that they really love this edit and that it was so cool, and I was so confused because I was like, this is probably halfway one of the worst edits I've seen. Like, it was just messy. It was just, like, all over the place. It's not my favorite. I like the idea of the edit, but it just did not come out the way that I wanted it to. But that compliment was so, so sweet, and I was so mind-blown by it because I was like, wow, like, I thought this edit was honestly a scrap. Like, and she thinks this is so cool and that this is, like, out of the box when, like, this was, like, I was a little insecure about it, so I'm still insecure about it. Like, I just watch it and I'm kind of like, this is such a mess. But that compliment was obviously so, so sweet. So even when you get to a point of editing to where, like, you're actually good, you're just gonna have edits sometimes that you're really insecure about. And so this one was one of them, the edit that I remade from Lauren. And then the first one, with the song called Knock Knock. Oh my god, I kept that edit on my page because one day I considered taking it down because I was like, this is so bad. And I only ever like keeping up edits that I think are decently good. But some of the edits that I have up, oh my God, I'm so sorry. Like, my throat was like so annoying right now. But anyway, that's why I like keep pausing, because I keep having to like take a breather. Oh my God, I literally feel like I ran a marathon. Am I okay? Okay, anyways, I almost took that edit down because like I was like super insecure about it, like the first one, the Knock Knock song with the remake from Lauren, because I was like, this just, oh my God. And it's actually really funny because that was the first edit that went viral, and then my TikTok from there grew up. It just like grew. But I remember too, like when I was reading those comments, like some people were like rude and they were like, oh my God, this is so, this one person I will never forget. This one person was like, don't listen to everybody else, this edit is, and then I can't say the word because I don't want this video to get flagged, but they basically were saying like it was garbage, and it was just so funny because I was like, if you're so bothered by it, like why don't you go remake it yourself? Like, people just really are looking at this edit and just being like, this is so embarrassing, ha ha ha. But like, if you actually look at Lauren's edit, like that is not easy to make. Like, these people just like, do these people not understand that these edits are actually hard? And you think because I use After Effects that I should be this god at editing? So like, I didn't care because there was a lot of us other nice people, and I think I responded to it though, and I was just like, yeah, no thanks, I will still listen to other people because they're actually nice and their opinions matter way more than yours. Because it's true, it's like, why the heck would I like take my time out of my day to like really look at you and be like, oh my God, they think it's bad, so it's bad. Like, but I am insecure about it and I hate watching it. It's like one of my worst. But I didn't take it down because of people like that, because I'm like, no, people get to actually watch that edit and then watch my reasons and see that I've gotten far. And so that was like the purpose. And so I left it there because like I did work hard on it, even though it didn't come out like Lauren's. I edited that knowing it wasn't gonna be like Lauren's, and I posted it for a reason, and so I kept it there. I don't like to rewatch it because I cringe, but there's that one person out there that watches it and they think it's so cool, and that's like the best feeling ever, because that's the whole purpose on why I make edits, like for me, myself, and for the people that edit, and other people out there that enjoy my content. And not everyone is gonna enjoy my content, and I'm perfectly fucking fine with that. Not everyone is gonna enjoy my content, and I'm like, I'm fine with that. So I kept it up, and so every time I feel like an edit, the only time I will not keep up an edit, if I really do not think it's good enough to stay on my page, and it just doesn't work with the song and it's like insanely messy, that is the only time I will actually take it down. But if it's decent-ish enough, and maybe I'm just insecure about it, I'll leave it up. If other people like really, really like it, I mostly leave it up. So I try not to delete them, even if I think it's like the worst. But that edit just wasn't the worst edit ever. It could be so much better, but it wasn't the worst edit ever, so I left it up. And almost any edit that people just think sucks or whatever, because I'm like, I've made worse, and it's just kind of how I look at it. So, oh my God, I literally feel like I've been talking like I ran a marathon. Like, this is so insane. This is not a podcast, and I'm just like going on and on. So with that being said, I hope this makes sense. We've all started off like just being absolutely terrible, like every single one of us, and people are always going to be really nice and be like, this is so good, even if it sucks, because those comments are kind of what help you keep going, and they're so lovely, and just people are so nice, and there's people out there that really think it's so good, even if it's like the most garbage thing you've ever made. So I just wanted to motivate you and to keep going, because you can go from edits looking like that to way better than mine. Even like my most recent, like I just feel like every other editor is more talented. I've seen people more talented than me. It's like I've gotten to a place where I decently know how to edit, and I'm still insecure, but it's still fun. It's still fun. But I know that people are just better at doing styles better than I am. And even you, even if you don't auto-edit and you use VideoStar, whatever you use, I promise if you keep going, you will make edits way better than all of these. And I can't wait to see them. I love watching edits. And yeah, even Lauren admitted that she feels like a lot of editors are better than her, which is so insane because we all know Lauren is just like so good at these edits. I like, oh my God, like 2 years ago when I was editing like complete garbage, I would look at her edits and being like, I wish I could make this. And I was like so upset over it. And I just still kept going and I still don't edit like her. And I think that that's actually a good thing because then, I don't know. Because I don't need to be like Lauren, and neither do you, and neither does the next person. So, like, I just think that everyone having their own unique style is cool. And so I have my own unique style, and I just go with it. But I'm still insecure. But I still have a lot of fun coming out with these edits. So I really hope that you watching this help you, and it will help you keep going. Because I would literally love to see your edits. If you want to see all of my old edits from like as many accounts as I can remember that I have edits up, I will put a screenshot of those accounts and you can go watch them and see how horrendous they are. And then you can also follow, like, I mean, not follow, you don't have to follow me. Oh my God, I'm not that YouTuber that's like, please subscribe and follow me on here. Like, oh my God, I don't care if you don't follow me. But if you want to watch my edits and see like my other edits, like, here's like I was about to say screenshot. Oh my God, here's like the screen of like all of these accounts if you want to go watch them and see how horrendous I was. And that's basically it. If you want a part two of just seeing more trash edits that I've made, let me know because I actually would love to do a part two. And I'm gonna stop talking now because this feels like I am talking in a podcast and this is not a podcast. Bye.